people do a very good job at finding patterns in things, especially things that they're not familiar with. And today, since it's Valentine's Day, we're looking at astronomical objects that have a shape of a heart. So you might not think it, but on the surface of Mars, we've actually found quite a few hearts. These are various images that were taken from the Mars Global Surveyor on the surface. So in each of these, you can actually see clearly the shape of a heart. Most of them are dips, so they're actually depressions in the surface. So in this one, you can see clearly this heart structure, and it's a depression in the ground. If the light's coming from the left, you can see the cliff right here has a dark side, and it's illuminating this side of the cliff. This one I particularly like because it's a crater with a heart that's in the middle of the crater. So the crater goes down into the surface, and then the heart actually pops up from the center, so it forms a mesa.
This is an example of how human beings love to find patterns in anything that they can. Just like when we stare up at the sky on a sunny day, try to find patterns in the clouds. In astronomy, the same thing kind of happens, and interesting looking objects tend to get nicknames. One class of interesting objects are called nebulae, and these are big clouds of gas in our galaxy. And they're where stars are born. So we often call these nebulae by interesting nicknames based on what they look like. There's the hourglass, the cat's eye, the owl, the lagoon nebula, the boomerang. But today, for Valentine's Day, we're showing you the Hart Nebula. So you can see this beautiful heart-shaped pattern here, which is glowing hydrogen gas. That gas is glowing because in the middle of this nebula is a knot of stars.
So this is one of my favorite galaxy pairs. This is the Antennae Galaxies. And these are actually two separate galaxies that are coming together in a marriage of the two galaxies to become one. So maybe a billion years ago, these were actually separate galaxies. And so they've been orbiting each other and getting closer and closer. And you can see now that the two are really coming together to form one. And you can see these wings of stars and gas. So it's called the Antennae Galaxy because they think these are the antennae that look kind of like a bug's antennae. And a more updated version of this with the Hubble Space Telescope is this image. So it just zooms in on that central region and you can really see this nice romantic heart shape.
Okay, so we're going to move away from hearts for the moment. But I am going to show you an image that has something to do with Valentine's Day. This is probably one of the most romantic images made, if you think of romance not just being about love, but about big ideas. The connection with Valentine's Day is that 20 years ago, a little spacecraft called Voyager 1, shooting out to the outer reaches of the solar system, its mission finished to explore the planets, was commanded to turn around and take a family portrait of our solar system. And of course, the connection with Valentine's Day is that it was on February 14th, 1990, 20 years ago, that this little spacecraft was sent the instruction to turn around, its mission completed, and start taking a picture of our solar system family. And this is the picture it took. It was 4 billion miles away from the sun, and it went and took 60 different pictures stitched together here in this panorama that capture almost all of the members of our solar system family. So you see the sun in the center, Earth and Venus very close by. Unfortunately, it missed out Mars and Mercury, but it got all the rest of the planets, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Aside from the grandeur of this whole picture put together, it's really one particular frame of this that captured the public's imagination. And that is, of course, the portrait of Earth, because that's our home. And so if we zoom in on that one little picture, you're seeing a picture of Earth from 4 billion miles away. And Earth is this little tiny dot right in the center. So the remarkable thing about this particular image is that it really gives us a perspective on our place in the solar system and just how small and insignificant our precious little home is. This is a tiny little dot in this one little picture, and that's Earth, that's our home. But really, I'm just paraphrasing a great scientist, Carl Sagan, here, because he had some much more profound words to say about this. He said, "Look again at that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. He goes on to call it a mote of dust suspended in a sunbeam. And that's absolutely true, because it is this little dot. It happens purely by chance to be caught on some reflected light within the camera coming from the sun.